So, we're sitting in a water cube. We're sitting with
James Ohayo,
as you can see,
communication officer for the water sanitation infrastructure branch at UN Habitat.
UN Habitat.
Yes.
So, James, tell me a little bit about what you're doing here, what your impressions are.
Well, I've been. This is my third year at the World Water Week. And each year, one of the things that really concerns me is that where are the people we talk about? Where are the representatives of the 2.5 billion people without sanitation and the 1 billion people without water? Mm-hmm. We have professionals in the sector. We have government representatives. We have the NGO sector represented here.
Yeah.
But I do not see, that I do not hear the voice of any of those 2.5 billion without sanitation or any of the 1 billion without water.
Mm-hmm.
And
how would you see that voice? I mean, we cannot fly 1 billion people into Stockholm.
Sure, we can't. But you know, in the '60s and seventies, for example, in my country Kenya, which is where I come from, poverty was synonymous with illiteracy and lack of education. But over the last 10 years or so, what has happened is that we have had university students who graduate, they don't have a job, so they end up living in the slums. So they actually can articulate the voice of the poor. And I think we should think about getting them here to address the issues. I think they'll be in a better position to articulate those issues than some of us who are professionals in the sector.
Yeah. Now, that's interesting you said, because we were actually talking among ACFO. We now have the water video cube. This is going to be online. People can see it.
Right.
But we were thinking about, is it possible to do like a video conferencing Skype and then get the voices of the poor directly? So if there's a seminar going on, we get a Skype link to the slum in Nairobi or something in Kibera, and then we ask them about it. Would that be a good idea, you think?
I think it would be a brilliant idea, because I think we'll get some perspectives from them that we as professionals may have been blindsided about, because they experience the problems day in and day out. Most of us a distance from the problem. We have an intellectual understanding of the issues, but we don't really have a practical experience of what they go through. I'll give you an example. In Nairobi right now, we have a serious water shortage. But you see, where I live, we have not suffered from a lack of water, because in spite of the rationing, because I live in a middle class area, we have not been cut off. But they get cut off, not just for a short period, but for long periods. There are people who haven't had water in their taps
for two, 3 weeks. Two, 3 weeks.
Even more for some people.
Yeah.
So we really need to hear from them. You know, the people who wear the shoe know best where it pinches.
Yeah. So we need a new, after all these years, I mean, are you still optimistic? I mean, there's a whole week of experts.
Yes.
Some good will come out of it, right? Or are you still too skeptical that...
I am not really a skeptic. I'm an optimist by nature. And I do believe that this forum helps to address some of the issues and hopefully, you know, alleviate the suffering of some of these people. What I'm trying to say is that if the voices of the people who suffer the most were to be heard, the pressure on the people who should do something about it, namely the politicians, would be much greater.
So we need to, the politicians need to be woken up.
Yes.
By the poor again.
Yes, and indeed some of them, more of them ought to be coming here.
Yeah.
Because we don't have that much representation at the political level here, at the level necessary to take the necessary action to deal with the issues. We may have political representation, but it's a fairly low level.
Yeah.
I mean, we probably have 2-3 ministers coming each year.
I don't think any more
than that. But if
we need the presidents here.
We need the presidents, yes. I mean, I know that last year we had the president of Madagascar, but unfortunately
he got killed.
He's no longer in power, you see. Well, we need more of those people here. And then we put them across the table from the people that they should be serving.
And then we get to
Skype. And then we really get a good debate going, and, you know, people saying, you know, you are not doing what you should be doing, and people and the politicians saying, yes, we're doing our best, but, you know, you are not playing your role as well.
Yeah.
Because even the poor have a role to play in solving their problem. I don't think we should take the view that because people are poor, they are unable to help themselves.
Yeah.
I believe, coming from a fishing village on the shores of Lake Victoria, don't give me fish, teach me to fish. Because if you give me a fish, tomorrow you won't be there.
Yeah.
And I'll die hungry, and the lake is right next to me. So teach me to fish, and I think we should adopt the same philosophy with the poor. you know, help them to help themselves,
yeah,
rather than hand them out, you know, charity, as it were.
Yeah.
And just because people are poor doesn't mean that they love to be, you know, the recipients of charity. A lot of the poor people also would like to find ways to help themselves out of their poverty.
Be more creative.
To be more creative, to yeah. offer solutions to their problems.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you very much. If there's anything more you want to say?
Well, I just want to say, coming from Kenya, which is an athletics country, first of all, congratulate Usain Bolt for that wonderful run last night.
That was great, huh?
9.58.
He was like flying.
Yeah, I mean, the guy was flying. He could hardly stop after he crossed the finishing line. And I just want to wish the Kenyan team in Berlin all the very best. Bring the gold home and show those Ethiopians one or two things about what we can do.
Did you hear that, Ethiopia?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, James.
My pleasure. I think it's a brilliant idea what you're doing here. And I think we need to give the poor a real voice, to get their voice heard, to get the politicians, to force the politicians to hear the voice of the poor, rather than for us to speak for the poor. Because we and the politicians are not very different. I could be a member of parliament or a minister next year.
If you can just word it right.
Yeah.
Is that good enough for you, Thomas?
It's brilliant. That's exactly what I need. Thank you.
Thank you.